Even when the stronghold comes, oh God, even when the enemy stands around us, oh God, but God, teach us how to rely on you and your word, God, in the name of Jesus. For we wrestle not against the flesh and blood, but against the evilness, oh God, of this world, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you, Lord God, for being real in our life, in our soul, oh God. We ask you, oh God, if you would remember this church, oh God, as a whole, oh God, in the name of Jesus, we will give you blessing, oh God. We will praise you. We will lift you up, oh God. We will magnify you. We, God, will love you the more, oh God, in the name of Jesus. 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 In Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of your God. Here we find a man in the book of 1 Kings chapter 19. That the Lord said to Elijah, show the people what God can do. One of the things you got to understand here in this 19th chapter is that here is an anointed man of God that's on the run. It does not matter what you think and what you feel. The enemy is not concerned about your feelings. He don't care what you think. He don't care what motivates you. The enemy wants you to be on the run. And there are so many saints that are afraid of the enemy that they are on the run right now. Watch this. Number 18. And if you will go into the 17th chapter and the 18th chapter coming up to the 19th chapter, you would find out that Elijah was demonstrating something that, amen, that the people had never seen before. They had never seen rain in heaven, and Elijah called rain to come down. Now, as he adventured from that particular setting, and he goes over to, amen, chapter number 18, he comes to the people that was worshiping Baal, and, amen, he tells them, you two, amen, you don't worship. Would it be God, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, or the God of Jacob? Amen. The people were standing around and they was wondering, amen, what kind of God did, amen, Elijah have? Amen. Elijah said, I tell you what, you call on your God, Baal, and we'll call on my God, amen, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It was known throughout the land of Judea, Samaria, and Jerusalem about the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Amen. This God was not to be messed with or to be played with. Amen. This God was an awesome God, a powerful God. Amen. Not the one that was standing, amen, on blocks or statues or built in a museum, with hands. But this God was the Lord of heaven. They, amen, saw, amen, the demonstration, amen, that Elijah, amen, was doing when he called down fire. And when the people seen that their God did not prevail, Elijah began to make fun of them. And he said, maybe founding, amen, of the sacrifice. Glory to God. They saw this, and the people fell on their face, as if in fear of Abraham and Isaac, God, amen, because they had already heard how terrible this God was when it came to his people. Glory to God. Now, here's the thing, amen, when we adventure into the nature chapter, this same man that caused rain to come, the same man that caused fire to come down, he received a letter from Jezebel, amen, a woman, amen, and he got on the run. Wow, hallelujah.